All right, guys, so this is the next project for the day. It's a dump bed style trailer. These are very handy trailers, however they do have their problems, and this is the problem. Their material has torn, and you know, it happens, right? And unfortunately, you know, they try to repair it and gets all bubble gummed, and it is what it is, right? They're that's what happens. The culprit, of course, is too thin a material. And you know, with companies trying to make the most profits possible, you know, they can kind of skimp on certain things, and this is understandable, right? It is, that's just the way business is. But when you try and engineer things, you would hope that this would be a little bit thicker or stronger, but you know, that's for them to decide. And so these issues come up. These guys will tear and get busted up, most likely because they probably opened this door and it hit on the ground as they're, you know, dumping this trailer. You know, who knows, but it's an issue now. So my thoughts are to replace this with a thicker tube, at least 11 gauge. I don't know what this is. This looks like 16. That's pretty thin. And I could have gone with something thicker, maybe a 3/16 or so. But then if you go too overkill and you just transfer the problem onto somewhere else, and it would probably break over here. So a happy medium between the two is fine. So that's our goal. We're gonna cut this section off. Customer was asking if I could patch over this and then put the hinges back on. Yes and no. You know, I'm not a fan, as you've noticed, of patch plates, because the weight transfer of the stresses would be just transferred over to this edge of the plate, and it would just tear over there. So may as well just go with a whole thicker piece. That way it goes back on the way it's designed to go on, same surface area where this is mounted, that's mounted, put it back together, be good. So that's our goal for today. Get these off, unbolt them. I'll use a plasma cutter to cut these off, and I'll go more in detail as I once I get them off. So let's go. Step one is down, got the doors off of there. Next step is to kind of look over what needs to be cut off. So obviously these hinges will need to be cut off there and there, but if we look a little closer, we looked at it, you can see that it was welded up in there, and then you see that this, let me lay this down. Okay, we can see that this has been welded along this perimeter, stitch welded in certain areas, which is good. So what we will be doing is we'll be cutting it out, cutting the tube out, and leaving the material. This, it looks like a weld at least. And you just run, I'm going to use a plasma cutter, just plasma cut in that direction, cut against the tube, cut at an angle this way, cut the tube only. And I may just cut this line here, even though it overlaps, it may be fine. We'll see how much success I have in peeling it off. But once we do, or sorry, once I start having some areas here cut free, then I might be able to see where I can just peel that tube off and leave it all original. So we'll see. Nothing but a step for a stepper, as I say. All right. All right, so our goal for today, or right now, is to separate this piece from this piece. And what I will do is I will cut right in that weld at a slight angle that way to try and see if I can get the separation line between the hinge and the square tube. That way I can break it free and be able to access this tube a little easier. So let me try that first. Thank you. No, it's looking like it's full of dirt because the top didn't have a cap on it, so that's why it's struggling. Okay, we can see here, full of dirt. So, no big deal though. Now we can focus on cutting this direction, cutting that tube off of there. I'll clean that up right quick. Now that that's cleaned up, now I can see where I'll need to cut a little bit better, trim that edge there to keep separate this piece in the tube. And similar to this here, I can cut at this angle like this. I will be flipping this door over, and I know it's stitch welded, but if I cut back about 3/16 of an inch just behind the stitch weld, that'll create a new edge for me all the way across. That'll be good too, no big deal. And just continue trimming this, and hopefully this tube will just peel right off in pieces, but it'll peel right off. So let's keep going. All right, so we can see there that one of the pieces fell off, and on this side here, this still is attached here, but what I did here, I was long arcing it and traveling in the backwards motion to keep from affecting the parent metal skin. So you could see the division between the two metals as I was using the plasma, just long arcing it, and it was blowing all the slag backwards. So the reason this one didn't fall off is because I hadn't finished this edge yet. So a little bit more there, a little bit of probably hammering or prying. Same thing here, we'll have to kind of clean that up a little bit better. Long arc it, try and get through there. It doesn't look like it's attached on the bottom side, so that should come off with a little bit of ease. And then be a cleanup, put in a new tube, and we're done with this side. Let's keep going. There you go. What's the problem? Okay, that came out all right. A little bit of chewing, right? You keep chewing until it comes off. And I hadn't seen that little tack there. That's what was giving me problems at the end. But it all came off rather nicely. So just cleaned it up with a wire brush, flap disc, clean up these edges. I'll make sure that's good enough to weld. I'm running 030 wire, so that'd be perfect for this material size. So just cut that one there to the right proper length. Same thing with the other door. So that's what I'm gonna do. Let me swap these out and start cutting on the other one. I'm gonna try something a little bit different this time. I'm going to cut the bottom side of this first to see if I can break it free from the square tube, and that way it peels off a little easier. But you know, either way, it's gotta come off. So let's see what happens. Thank you. it's getting there. Not bad. Man, get my phone. Well, excellent. That one came out even easier than the first one, of course, because, you know, naturally you get used to what to expect. And so this one came off much nicer. Now it's just a matter of cutting some square tubes to length and jamming it back in there and welding her up. So let me get that cleaned up and start cutting.
fitting. Like a glove.
Yeah, looking good. Pretty decent fit up. It's down here as well. Looks good. Nothing but a step for a stepper. So, I don't know. I guess I'll high speed this one and I'll show you some of the welding on the next one. Well, there you go. This wasn't so bad. Got a little pinhole there, but little black paint doesn't hurt. Black paint covers a multitude of sins, right? As far as welding on this side, little stitch welds just like the factory, so we're good. Let's get the other door done. We'll be right back. Okay, so we got them finished up. It's looking really good. And now the next thing is to determine what to do with these hinges here. I was gonna try and just hammer them and straighten them out, but it turns out they've recessed in there. So much so that these guys will not run in parallel. Or not parallel, but in line. So I may try and cut it with a cutoff disc or something to try and straighten them out. I don't like that they're not. That's probably what's causing a lot of the problems. Too much force is working on the skin, or sorry, the tube of the door. Psst. Hey, and creating issues to where it's always warping and flexing. So this is the worst of the two, but I think I'm gonna cut those off. Either that or just buy new ones, because the other parts, the actual part that attaches to the door is bent as well. So it may be best just to get new ones and be done with it. So a little pause until I can go get those. Hang on. All right, so I picked these guys up. Customer, or the sales guy, says these are only left-handed because the way the bolt's facing. Just turn them around. Of course, I'll have to change the bolt. Or do I? It's lock-nutted. Either way, I opted to go that route instead of trying to straighten these guys out, because these guys are all bent up and it'd just be kind of a mess. And so for the same amount of time, it would take me to straighten those out correctly, grind them down, make them clean, just buy new ones. So much easier that way. Okay, so being as how these guys don't line up either, those will just cut off. And instead of trying to beat them and pull them, when I set them up, you know, they may have a little gap because of the recessed area in here. That's what the MIG welder's for. Fill it up. So cut them off, put new ones on, put the doors back on, ship it. So almost there. Let's keep going. Ta-da. A little cleaner with a flap disc. Okay, so that takes care of that. Got them sanded flush. This one here, I left a little bit of metal on there, only because this got kinked in that way, and just left a little bit of that weld to hopefully help build it up or straighten it out when I put them back on. So Next is to put these hinges back on and get them lined up. Here we go. Okay, next is putting these hinges back on to help line it up. What I did is I got a washer on the end of this half inch rod. Basically, we're just gonna tack weld one of them right there, tack weld the other one down there, make sure it's lined up, and that way they're running pretty parallel and straight. So that's next. Something like that. Right on. Pretty simple. Let me get those welded out. One side down. Next side. Okay, so the next step is to put these doors on, and from what I remember last, there was about a 3/8 gap underneath from the bottom of the door to the underside, bottom of the trailer to the underside of the door. So I've got this piece of flat bar in here to act as that spacer. Now I'll basically just stand these guys up on the end and clamp these guys in position where they go, and just ensure that they work. Put a couple tacks, see if they swing open, and see if they close as well. So let's do that next. Okay, that looks pretty good there. I don't like that this has still got a big gap. This turns out to be the right measurement. However, I think I will go ahead and put a slight gap in this spot here to make it latch a little better in these spots right here so it doesn't open up. So let me find some shim material, probably some 11 gauge or just something to give it some space. So, all right, next up. Okay, that'll do it. Let's fast forward this welding. Done. Came out okay.
Pretty good.
Hopefully they won't have any more problems, which of course they will. They'll end up banging this on something, but it'll hold for now. So a little bit of this and we are done. So thank you guys for watching, and we'll catch you guys on the next one.